Holy Spirit. That is as declared, as give, as received witness. The Bible said in Romans chapter 8, verse 16, please. Romans chapter 8, verse 16 said, the Spirit of the Lord bear witness with our own spirit that we are the children of God. The Spirit of God bear witness with our own spirit that we are the child of God. That is where the scripture for this month is extracted from, I am a child of God, by the Holy Spirit, or as declared by the Word of God. And our teaching series that we started yesterday is, ye are God, the Son of Mosai. That is extracted from the book of Psalm 82, verse 6, Psalm 82, verse 6. And yesterday, I started on a topic that I was, you know, started teaching yesterday, the pathway to knowing yourself from Scripture. The pathway to knowing yourself from Scripture. Today, I'll be doing another subtitle, and I titled this, Do You Understand? Do You Understand? For those who are just joining us, yesterday we started the title, The Pathway to Knowing Yourself. If you don't know yourself, people will give you description of what you are not. If you don't know yourself, people will tell you about what you are not. If you don't know yourself, you will never amount to what God has designed you. And one of the things that I said yesterday, that to know yourself, you must know what is written about you. And I said, if you don't like to read the Bible, it's okay. But I want you to know that the Word of God is a seed. The word that you don't read will never give you the seed that you need. And until the seed is sown, it cannot die. And every seed must die. The seed must be sown, the seed must die, and every dead seed will germinate. Every germinated seed will grow again. And when it grows again, then you cannot harvest. I want to read five things I told you yesterday that you need to know from the Word of God to know yourself, is that you must find the Word as being written concerning you. You find the Word, you believe it. When you believe it, you speak it. When you speak it, you trust it, and when you trust it, you stay with the Word. Because if you can stay, the Bible says, he that endure to the end, the same shall be saved. And we're going to continue the part two of the pathway to knowing yourself as a child of God. You must know yourself. And today, I'll be telling you, if you started reading the Bible, what are the things you need to understand? What are the things you need to discover? What are the things you need to put your energy to do? Because if you don't do what is needed for you to do, then you will just be labor in vain. Like you are trying to, you are trying to lose weight, but you are still, you run, you do push-ups, you do all kind, but you are still eating all kind of calorie. That will not be good. Less calorie, more burning. I think with that, you can reduce weight. On the same way, what are the things you need to know as a child of God? Though you are reading this Bible, do you understand how to go about it? That's what we are teaching about today. Do you understand the pathway to knowing yourself from Scripture? Do you understand? In the book of Acts chapter 8, verse 32, a eunuch who was, you know, who came to a particular place to buy stuff, he was reading the book of Isaiah. But he lacked understanding of what he was reading. He does not understand, but the Spirit of the Lord came on Philip and said, hey, join yourself with that child on that note. He asked him in verse 30, he said, do you understand what you read? Do you understand what you're reading? You pick the Bible, and the Bible said, Jesus took away your infirmity. And some people have hard time to, let me tell you something. One of the ways that I know that some people will never succeed is anytime you doubt authority. If you doubt authority on a subject matter, even when you know you can succeed. Because what happened? Investment of some people determine what they say. When Bishop Oyedepo was teaching about, I can never be sick. I just lay on it and I took it. I have never been sick for long. I can never be poor. I lay hold on something. You know, I said something today. What I did for free is what they've been paying me thousands of dollars Now, what I did for free from 2016, 2017, 2020, let me tell you something. God cannot lie. God cannot what? God cannot lie. I come to ask you again. Do you understand what you are reading? If you pick the word of God to know yourself, do you understand what you are reading? Let me tell you, how the things that you must understand from the scripture, that is what I'll be teaching you today. Remember Proverbs 21 verse 16, Proverbs 21 verse 16. It said, a man that wanders away from the way, from the pathway of understanding, shall abide in the congregation of the dead. You can read what, you know, Mike Morrow says something, is the knowledge is acquisition. He said wisdom is application, and he said understanding is comprehension. You can acquire it, you can apply it. If you cannot comprehend it, you will lose it. How? It is not all that you do that you get instant results. It is not all that you have invested in, you know, that you get instant results. Sometimes the investment will test you. I remember those days when I was in Lagos, I was walking on my feet. I launched my feet very early in the morning, 5, and begin to walk across the street. Oh Lord, let there be an intervention. Let many people know you. Nobody knows. Bishop never announced anything. I'm just doing my own thing as being led by the Spirit. Let me tell you something. God pays. All those time of investment, God pays. Can I tell you something? If you don't know God, if God has not given you a deliberate, clear, vivid instruction on what to do, check your relationship with God. Do you understand what you're reading? Do you understand your relationship with God? The Bible said, those who know their God, they shall be strong. Why you go to church, you don't go again? Because you don't understand. Why you take a preaching of the man of God and you trivialize it because you don't understand? Why you slap your wife or abuse your husband is because you don't understand. Why you take the entire money or your paycheck that God gives to you and you don't give tithes, you don't give offerings, because you don't understand. When understanding comes, motivation and inspiration becomes the order of the day. When understanding comes, motivation and inspiration becomes the order of the day. If somebody needs to wake you up, if somebody needs to tell you, if somebody needs to remind you, it's because what happened? You lack understanding. I come to ask you today, do you understand? Do you understand? It's a month that I'm a child of God by the Holy Spirit. Yes. Holy Spirit said, but do you understand what are the things that is needed to know? Let me give you two things you need to know about understanding. Understanding, lack of understanding is the highway to doubt. If you start doubting yourself, it's because of you lack understanding. Last year, I was giving a particular amount of money to 4 or 5 people that my wife and I, we are, you know, we believe in the anointing, and God said, hey, follow them. And we give them money. And December last year, Holy Spirit said, double it. Double it. I said, what? Double it. So every month, let me tell you something. If you are being coerced to give, it's because you don't understand. Write this down. Write this down. I don't care who you serve, who you don't serve. I don't care the church you go that you don't go. I don't care if you fast and you pray. To be financially free is on the platform of giving. Only fool doubt to be financially free. God said, hey, you know, the poor will not be away from your land. But for you, if you don't want to be poor, open your hand wide. If you don't take care of people, God will never trust you with his resources. What is wealth? Wealth is God's provision, trusted in man's hand to distribute and make available to those who are in need. But I'm not talking about financial prosperity today, but that's going to be a lesson for another day. So, when you lack understanding, doubt sets in. When energy goes away, that's because there is lack of understanding. When you don't love your, I tell people, I said, divorce is a process. To be poor is a process. No, nothing just happened. Everything happened just. For something to happen, because what? Something has been happening. Something has been happening. Somebody shout hallelujah. So, lack of understanding is the way to doubt. Number two, lack of understanding is the sure way to lose self-esteem. If you don't have understanding, you will doubt yourself. You will not be able to compete where your equals are standing. On that note, I'll be sharing with you tonight, briefly, on seven powerful things that you must understand in life. To know yourself, you must understand these seven power secrets. To know yourself, you must understand. If you don't, you are by yourself. You can read that, you know, somebody's... Let me tell you something. If you think God will reveal to you what he has revealed in 1800 to some people that has been put in a book instead of you to go and buy that book, and you are still waiting on God, you are by yourself. There are some things God will not tell you that God has told some people. You have to go there. He said, go to them that sell and buy. Because of time, the fourth power secret, the first one out of seven, is the power of devotion. You cannot know yourself until you are devoted. What is devotion? What is devotion? Daily self-task towards the discovery of a missing link in your life. Daily self-task towards the discovery of the missing link in your life. Let me tell you something. When you are devoted, there are things you do. Either it's convenient or it's not convenient. There are things you do. There are things you put into your spirit. There are things you avoid. There are things you inject. One of the things, there are things you connect with. Devotion increase your capacity for discovery. Devotion is what you do it daily. No matter how tired you are, you must do it. What? Show me a man who is doing something daily. I don't care what that thing is. You know what? That person will be rewarded. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. You know, in the early church, in Acts chapter 5, verse 42, the Bible said, and daily in the temple, the law of devotion. Daily in the temple, the law of devotion. Daily in the temple and in every house. They cease not to teach and to preach Jesus Christ. That is their devotion. Do you understand that as a child of God, if you have nothing that you are devoted doing, the enemy will beat you. Go and see. The richest men, you know, in the world right now, maybe they don't even go to church. But, you know, I overheard one of the interview of Edamon, or what do they call this guy, second richest man? Edamon, yes. He said, for 22 months, he slept on the floor of his factory, where he's trying to discover his, the car. When he was one who built paper, when he sold paper, he took the money and was trying to build what they called it, something to go to the mat, and was trying to build a car without gas. He said for 22 months, it was when he was about to marry, that was when he went to go and buy a house. Daily devotion. Daily devotion. Daily devotion. Daily devotion. I think 2014, the last time I was in Nigeria, and I just left and went to go and see Papa, Bishop Oyedepo. At 2:01, Papa called all the pastor back for to come and pray and thank God for that night. Come to ask you tonight, what are you doing daily? What are you doing daily? What are you doing daily? You cannot escape the reward of your daily investment, and you cannot escape the penalty of the sin. Somebody say devotion.
Devotion.
Somebody say devotion.
Devotion.
Somebody say devotion.
Devotion.
When you are consistent with your devotion, it will lead to discovery. The second power secret in the school of understanding. So when you read this Bible every day, what are the things that you discover in it? When you are devoted to it, you will discover something. What is discovery? Discovery simply, it is unveiling of the hidden treasure of life by the force of engagement of night mystery. Discovery is hidden at night. Show me a man who is up when everybody is sleeping, and I will show you another man who will be sleeping when everybody will be walking. Show me a man who will not make his eyes to determine his destiny, and I will show you a man who the entire world will stand up. You know, go and look at how Bishop Edeko looks. His eyes is not open like this. He's always closed like this because he won't sleep. He has to teach, preach at 6 o'clock, but he will sleep by 4. A man almost 70, 67 by September this year. For devotion, every devotion we need to discover. One day he was teaching, Bishop Edeko came to the United States then. I was the one in charge of Wheeler Chapel, San Antonio. And he said, I think I'm not permitted to say it. Let me forget that one. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Daniel chapter 2, verse 19. When the king dreamt, and the king does not have an answer, and the king he vowed to kill all the wise men in the land, and Daniel was involved. And this is what Daniel said. He said, please give us time. At night, you can never discover what will make you a leader during the day if you don't make use of your night. Every discovery is hidden at night. If you are a night man, you will take the lead during the day. If you are a night man, you will take the lead during the day. He said, there was the secret revealed to Daniel in the night vision. Discovery of every missing link is hidden in the engagement of the mystery of night. Discovery, a function of devotion. Discovery, a function of when you have used your day to be devoted to something, you will use your night to what? To discover something. This thing is cover. That's where the word discovery comes from. There is a thing, a treasure that is hidden somewhere. Nobody can find it. But at night, when everybody is sleeping, there is no distraction. You go there and what? And the word on discovery is uncover. It's there. You know, in the school of in graduate school, when you write a paper, they call it, I want to go and research. Yeah? When you come back, your doctor will tell you, no, it's there. They said, go and do what? Research. So if you can't find it, what will you do? Research it. Research simply means ability to stay all night. Looking at what has been done and looking for how to what? To add your own pattern to it. So the first power secret is what? Devotion. The second one is what? Discovery. The third one is what? Investment. For you to know yourself, for you to understand life, for you to maximize the child of God in you, according to Romans 8:16, you must invest in yourself. You must invest in yourself. The last one, you must invest in yourself. What is investment? Investment is simply the intentional involvement of your spirit, soul, and body with the mindset of producing results that will outlive you. Can I say it again? The intentional involvement of your spirit, soul, and body with the mindset to produce results that will outlive you. Anytime you die and you dead, you have failed. If you died and you are dead, you are failed. Those who rule the world are dead men. What makes you to live when you die? You live when you die when your produce, what you produce, is still very relevant. We are still using Bob today. We are still flying plane today. They are still building houses today. These are the discovery of some men. Bishop Oyedepo said something. He said, my journal that I have, the discovery that I have, the investment God has given to me. He said, my journal, if I leave this world, they will still publish 200% of the book I've written. He said, there are some things he will never share. Somebody say investment. Somebody say investment. Somebody say investment. Somebody say investment. It said intentional involvement of your spirit, soul, and body with the mindset to produce results that will outlive you. It will outlive, outlast you. This was how Jesus Christ responded. Matthew 24:37, Mark 12:30, and Deuteronomy 6:5. He said, you should love the Lord your God. You know, when you love God, then you can live your life. Remember? Matthew 24:37, Mark 12:30, Deuteronomy 6:5. The same thing. These scriptures are saying the same thing. You should love the Lord your God. Invest in loving God. If you love God, you will love his house. If you love God, you will love people. Number two, if you love God, God's business will be your business. You will love his word. You will love his house. You will love his people. You cannot invest in God and lack the word. The last time that Bishop was in the U.S. that I saw him that I knew about was when he said, listen. He said, some of you are saying, okay, this is U.S. You know, I have to do this. He said, listen. If you are not rewarded, it's simple. It's because you are not serving. He said, your reward is not in my hand. If you have my number, check my WhatsApp. I put it there today. He said, no. He said, if you are looking for reward, it's because you are not serving. He said, those who are really working, they don't check when are they paying. He knows that when he do what is right, what happened? People will do what is needed. Payment is always waiting for the worker. Thank you, Jesus. As an investment, your investment will compel other people's investment. Thank you, Jesus. Your investment in life. Don't just be a stupid child of God. Be a studious child of God. Help me to write it. Don't just be a stupid child of God that you don't understand your left from your right. When unbelievers speak, you are quiet. Because what happened? Your brain is not being taught. Write this down. God gives you brain not to disturb him. Anywhere you go, you are the salt. I said yesterday, you are the light. I said yesterday. But in chapter 5 of Matthew verse 16, God said, hey, let your own light shine. Let that light shine. Truly, you are the salt. But it takes work. A city that is set on a hill. Do you know what it is to build a house on a mountain? It takes hard work. If you don't want to live hard life, it takes hard work to get out of what? Hard life. It takes hard work to get out of hard life. It takes hard work to get out of... Let your life surround me. Then you will take lead in your life. It takes what? Love investment. Matthew 22:37. Mark 12:30. Deuteronomy 6:5. Starting from the power secret of devotion. The power secret of discovery. The power secret of investment. Number four, the power secret of association. Association. Show me a man. I'll show me your friend. And I will point to you the kind of person you are. You cannot separate the success of Esther from the mentoring of Mordecai. You cannot separate the investment of Naomi over Ruth. You cannot separate the success of Elisha from following Elijah. Neither can you separate the success of Joshua from the connection with Moses. Write this down. Anything that works is connected. I love that. Anything that works is connected. Little kabakata iPhone that is so powerful without an internet is a wasted phone. Anything that works is connected. For your life to work, you must be connected. Show me. You know, in America, we have a self-made millionaire. Self-made. It's a lie. There is nothing like that. I read a book. It's called Outlier. Outlier was saying that how some people, if you want to be successful, do something for 10,000, 10,000 hours, and everything's going to be. But something is said, look at all the people that are successful today. They have somebody mentoring them. You might not see that person behind the camera, but there is somebody giving them this, giving them that. So, what's the name of this? Bill Gates. I have to go and be begging for some people to give him a computer because he doesn't have one. Those people's names are not there. When you hear Bishop Oyedepo, he mentions from men of God, association is the highway to your distinction. Association is the highway to your decision. You know, you cannot attain to where God is taking you to without meeting some people. Let me tell you, no matter the level of prophecy that has gone ahead of you, there can never be a Timothy without a Saul. There can never be a Saul without the hand laying of an Ananias. Everything that works is connected. That what is connected. What's his name? Saul, who was not a prophet after he met with Samuel. Association. Samuel said to him, he said, listen, today you will prophesy. He said, how? I'm not a prophet. He said, don't worry about it. As you go, you will meet with the company of a prophet. When you stay around them, you begin to prophesy. Guess what? In verse 11 of 1 Samuel chapter 10, 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 11. The Bible said, what's going on here? Is Saul also among the prophets? Look for it. Is Saul also among the prophets? Is Saul also among the prophets? Is Saul also among the prophets? 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 11. Is Saul also among the prophets? Whoever you rub with will determine what will rub on you. The power of association. What is association? The capacity to connect with the right people who are doing the right thing and going the right direction to make right thing happen. The capacity to connect with the right people who are doing the right thing and going the right direction to make the right thing happen. Who you follow will determine what follows you. Blessed be the day. You know, there was somebody who led me to Bishop Oyedepo that gave me the book. He gave me the, what I call it, Breaking Financial Hardship. I read that book and the spirit of giving from Psalm 28 fell on me that day. The spirit of giving, it came upon me. You know, some of you right now, you are watching me, you are by yourself. It's a lie. You cannot go far until you meet people who are going far. You cannot go far. The day you want to fly yourself from US to Nigeria by yourself and you are not going to fly school, you will be grounded. You will know, you just need to connect with the flying company and they have paid the pilot that what that will take you there. Is Saul also among the prophets? Anything that works is what? Is connected. Don't forget about the law of the power secret of association. Some of you are, you know, all you just need is one person. Just one person. You just need one person who know one person who know one person according as God has planned it, and you are where you're supposed to be. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. May your soul connect with your Samuel. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. May your Elisha connect with your Elijah. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. May your Ruth never depart from your Naomi. In the mighty name of Jesus. May your Esther follow the counsel of Mordecai. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you are not listening to nobody, you will never be listening to. Until you follow authority, you can never be one. These are not agabra-cadabra. These are the laws of life. Everything that works is connected. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let me tell you something. Every PhD holder started from high school, from primary school. From primary school to what? Secondary school. Secondary school to college. You will not believe somebody who is a PhD that is standing on a board right now that is saying, no, you have to rewrite your paper. That person started from nobody. If you are not ready to be told, you will never teach. If you don't want somebody to give you direction, you will never get to the top. The power of association. 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 Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The secret power of life. Do you understand what you read? Don't forget, we start from what? The secret power of devotion. Number two, we move to the secret power of God, discovery. Number three, we move to the what? The secret power of investment. We move to secret power of what? Association. Now, we move to what? The secret power of activity for productivity. Activity for productivity. You can be a child of God and still be stupid. And inside your gene is the cell, the organ, the tissue, the system to be everything you want to be. Let me tell you something. If you are waiting for the right time, it will never come. If you are waiting for the big capital, it will never come. Let me tell you something. Everything that you need is within reach. Start with what you have. Everything that you need is within your reach. Start with what you have. God will never test you with $1 million if you have not passed the test of a dollar bill. Work with what you have so God will take you to where you want to be. You can think global but start what? Local. Until you can tell your story of your locality, you will never tell your story of your globality. There's anyone like that. You cannot just sit on a globe one day. You have to first start from the ground. Because if you don't start from the ground, you will never understand where people are when you get to the top. Jesus had to descend to the hell to conquer death. That was why when he rose up, he understood what the people are facing. The people that are in the hell with him. Before he rose them up. But he said, no, he said, you know what I'm going to do is that let me just intercede for them. Intersection. To get them out of there. You can never lead until you follow. What am I talking about? Don't worry about where you are. Just involve. Get involved. Wherever you are, get involved. If you have a dollar bill, work with it. Start something. It is called activity. But have the mentality of productivity. Activity. Never, ever be stagnant. Never, ever be useless. Get your hand dirty so you can have a mind of gold. Little sabaka, egora, butikata, kata, boniaba. Get your hand dirty so you can develop a heart of gold. Get your hand dirty so you can develop a heart of gold. Get your hands dirty, you can develop a heart of gold. Until you start small, you can never be able to what? To manage big things. Until you start small, you can never manage big things. Start small. Activity. Get yourself doing something. Get yourself doing something. Don't wait for big things. Start small. You know what happened? Let me give you the definition of big. What is big? Write it down. Big is small plus small. 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 When you total all the small together, it becomes what? Big. Every car that you see on the road, every standing building, everyone that gets to the top, they start here, they do it here, little there, little here. One day, everything clicks. They say it's a big person. It's a lie. They start small. Activity. Activity. activity, 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 activity. If you are called to speak, start speaking. If you are called to write, start writing. If you are called to serve, start serving. You can never get to the peak until you start at a small place. Activity. Don't wait for a greater day. There is nothing like that. There is no future. Write this down. Rotimi, what do you mean? There is no future. The future simply means today that is well spent. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. What is activity for productivity? It is engagement that fights idleness with the passion to eliminate stagnation with the mindset of progress. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm gonna see the definition again one more time. What is activity for productivity? It is what? It is the engagement, your deliberate, consistent, and active engagement. Put it like that, in bracket. Your deliberate, intentional activity that fights idleness. Don't ever, ever, in Matthew 20, Jesus Christ said, hey, whoa, why are you guys not working? He said, nobody gives the job. He said, no, go. Why are you idle? No, go and work, go and work, go and work. Say to the righteous, it shall be well with you. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 9, you shall eat the fruit of your own labor. It's not your husband, it's not your wife. If you are a woman, get up and work. There is dignity in labor. You can do YouTube video and make money. You can sell on Amazon and make money. Let your hand be busy and you will develop the mindset of gold. Little Sabra Kentaraba. Go back to my definition for the last time. It is engagement, your deliberate engagement that fights idleness with the passion to eliminate what? Stagnation with the mindset of progress. You should never be on the same spot. The path of the righteous is like a shining light that shines more and more and more until a perfect day. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. You know, in the book of Mark chapter 4, verse 31 to 32, a mustard seed, very small. He said it's nothing. Very small on the earth. It's less than the seed. On the, very, very small. But look at what verse 32 of Mark 4 said. Verse 32 of Mark 4. He said, as small as that mustard seed is, he said, when it is sown, when you get your hands dirty, when it is sown, the magic, or call it the miracle, it is when it is sown. When it is sown, what happened? It grew up. When it's sown, what happened? It becomes greater than the heart. When it's sown, what happened? It shooted out. When it grew, what happened? It developed great branches. Did you see? Just because it was sown. Activity. For what? For productivity. God will give us understanding in the mighty name of Jesus. I progress very fast. The next power secret that you need to understand as a child of God is the power secret of faithfulness. Faithfulness. Some people just do it today and tomorrow they say, I will do it again. And write it down. Anytime you go on break, you will break down. break things down. Break things down. Break things down. Somebody say to me, does that mean you should not go on? You should not take a break? Oh. Have you ever studied your Bible? Let me tell you something. You need to understand. That's why I titled this message, do you understand? You don't understand. There is what we call faithfulness. Your faith is food on something. What is it? What is that thing? In Genesis 1, God never rested until he worked for 6 days. Write this down. The ratio of rest to work is 6 to 1. Not 5 to 2. Don't make that mistake. It's ratio what? 6 to 1. not 5 to 2. Your Saturday is for deployment. Monday to Friday is for what? Employment. Somebody shout hallelujah. I will tell you the secret. Some people stay at home and watch Netflix. Netflix? How did Netflix become Netflix? Go and study it. Because people don't read books. You don't need to read books. Go and read biographies of company and see how that goes. The activity is too much. Go and look at how many companies that Netflix shut down for them to be at the top. Go and look at how many companies that Facebook rather cloned or buy them over. Go and look at how many companies that shut down because of Amazon. Let me tell you something. Faithfulness is not a religious word. It's an identification that you are on your way to the top. Faithfulness. Faith. Are you faithful to your marriage? Are you faithful to your family? Come on. Are you faithful in your career? Many people, the only certificate you have was your undergrad. And after 10, 15 years, you have not done your master. You have not done any course. And you are expecting a promotion. Who swear to you? Who cost you? Write this down. Only personal development attracts promotion. If you are not growing as a person, you are a danger to the company you are working for. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Faithfulness. Faithfulness. What is faithfulness? Faithfulness means it's a deliberate responsibility with total discipline, which have the capacity to register your name among the champions and proclaim you the best among the world best. I will say it again. What is faithfulness? What is faithfulness? What is faithfulness? Deliberate responsibility. You give yourself a task with a total discipline. Did you see that? Nobody needs to tell you what to do. You are there. You hold your own game. Your deliberate responsibility with total discipline, which have the capacity to register your name among the champions and proclaim you the best among world best. Proclaim you the best among the world best. Proclaim you the best among the world best. Faithfulness is not a religious word. It's an indication of those who... Can I show you a scripture? Pick your Bible, everybody. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 2. Please help me to type it. Some people have to read it on YouTube. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 2. If you find it before me, please read it. It is required from a steward to be faithful. You are a steward of your life. Be faithful. Be faithful. Be faithful. Be faithful. 1 Corinthians 4 verse 2. Moreover, it is required in steward that a man be found what? So one of the requirements of your life is faithfulness. It's faithfulness. It is required. It's a necessity. Faithfulness is what? It's needed. It's one of the arsenal of the champion. You must have it, or your life never counts. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let me round up tonight. Some people just say, what is he talking about? I bet you. If you can study the seven secrets I just showed it to you, I'm about to give you the seventh one. You study them, and you live your life by them, you will know that truly you are a child of God. The last one is the power secret of dedication. The power secret of dedication. Let's start. What is the first one? The power secret of what? Devotion. What is the second one? The power secret of what? Discovery. What is the third one? The power secret of what? Investment. What is the fourth one? The power secret of what? Association. What is the fifth one? The power secret of what? Activity for what? Productivity. What is the sixth one? The power secret of what? Faithfulness. What is the last one? The power secret of what? Dedication. What then is dedication? Dedication is a deadly commitment towards a cause. If you are not ready to die for it, it will never give you life. Life is inside death. What do I say? Life is inside what? Inside death. The death of Jesus Christ was the one that gives you and I life. If you're on Facebook, you're on Instagram, you're on Facebook, you will know that dedication, inside dedication is dead. You must be deadly committed to a cause. I know people on Facebook, I know they are on Instagram, and they are on YouTube. I want you to know today, write it down. What is it that you believe? What is it that you can die for? It is good to walk. But I want you to know, work with is an employment. You must move from a realm of employment to one realm of what? Deployment. In the military, when you leave your job, US military, to another people, to go and do a mission, they call it deployment. The power, dedication is the power behind focus, is the fuel behind distinct result. A distinct, what I mean by distinct, it means a clear, a vivid result. The result that can never be denied. I'll say it again. What is dedication? Dedication simply means deadly committed. To be deadly, a deadly commitment, that is, to be deadly committed to a cause. It is the power behind focus for result, and it is the fuel that gives you a distinct, a clear, a vivid result. In Acts chapter 6, verse 1 to 6 or 7, Acts chapter 6, when you start Acts chapter 6, and the church, the first church, note, was any church that you call it, was growing. People who were supposed to be teaching the Bible, praying, do you know what they're doing? They became the person serving food. And they realized that why they are serving instead of them to be reading the Bible and praying, they were busy serving food. So the effect on the altar was going down. And they cannot even succeed in what they are doing. They now said something was wrong. Acts chapter 6. Something was wrong. He said, listen, let's look for people who can do what we don't know how to do, so we can do what we need to do. Somebody said dedication. Dedication simply means know your capacity and stay with it. This is what I'm called to do. That's what I am doing. You know what happened? The 12 called them in verse 2. He said, the 12 called the multitude of disciples unto them and said, it is not reason that we should leave the word of God and serve him. Look at what happened in verse 4. Verse 4 of Acts chapter 6. He said, but we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. Guess what happened in verse 7? And the word of God what? Increased. Write this down. The end result of dedication equals what? Increase. If you are not increasing in your life, your ministry, your marriage, your love, your career, it's because you are not dedicated. You are missing your point. You are missing your line. Dedication, deadly committed to a cause. The power behind focus for results, and the capacity, the power behind distinct results that can never be challenged by men. On this note, I said to ask you tonight, do you understand what you are reading? You see, inside this Bible are things that you will never know if you will be, even you are Methuselah for 1,000 years. Hey, but how can you know yourself as a child of God? Maybe you should follow this 7-power secret that I told you, that I shared with you tonight, and your life will never remain the same. Stand up on your feet, everyone. Don't forget, the power secret number 7 is what? Dedication. The power secret number 6 is what? Faithfulness. The power secret of number 5 is what? Activity for productivity. The power secret of number 4 is what? Association. The power secret of number three is what? Discovery. No? Investment. Sorry. Number three. The power secret number three is what? Investment. The power secret number two is what? Discovery. And the power secret number one is what? Devotion. So devotion leads to discovery. Discovery leads to investment. Your investment needs what? Association. Your association needs what? Activity for productivity. And every activity for productivity needs your what? Your faithfulness. Your faithfulness is on the platform of what? Dedication. Lift up your hand and say, Lord, I receive the spirit of these seven forces. Pray that prayer in 1 minute. Lord, I receive the spirit for these seven forces to understand that I'm a child of God. Everything needed for me to make a landmark in this life, I will do it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I have been preaching when we started this ministry, January 2019. Can I tell you something? I have never preached two messages on a Sunday. Same message I need. Preaching different message each time. Let me tell you something. You will never know what you can do until you pray for God. God, help me. That's the prayer I want to pray. Oh Lord, help me to know what you have designed for me. Every hidden secret of my life, reveal them to me. Empower me to know what to do to go get them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Pray that prayer. Oh Lord, help me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, help me. Oh Lord, help me. Little sabra kita bato seke teleberi daba. Rabba kika koka baka katada kata dabala. Oh Lord, help me, help me, help me, help me. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can I tell you something? I gave my life to Christ in 2008. I started following Christ in 2010. From 2010 to now, I can't tell you how many impacts. I can't tell you how God has moved me from glory to glory. Let me tell you something. You can go to a winner and never be a winner. You can go to a redeemer and never be redeemed. You can go to Omega Phi Minister and never understand God as Alpha Omega. Let me tell you, beyond anybody you follow is your self-identification. You have to know yourself in Christ Jesus. Romans 8:16. He said, the spirit bears witness with our spirit that what? We are a child of God. I come to tell you today, when the pastor is not there, you will be challenged with life. Beyond preaching is what I cannot help you even when you are my son. I cannot help you even when you are my wife. I cannot help you even as a church member. You know, but I can only tell you the secret of life. The ability to leverage on the mystery of life, that's what makes you a conqueror. The ability to what? To leverage on life mysteries. That's what makes you a conqueror. Don't just go to church and cross your leg. Don't just listen to a preaching and be lost. Don't just write notes and never make impact. I want you to pray, oh Lord, help me. Let me know you and let me know myself in Christ Jesus. Let me know you and let me know myself. Empower me to move, to move, to move, to move. I will never be stagnant again. Pray that prayer. Open your mouth, everybody. Oh Lord, let me know you. Let me know you and let me know myself. Let me know you and let me know myself. Do you understand what you read? Little Sabra Kaba. Father, we thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In you then shall we know if you truly follow. We are a group of little youths in Winner then. And everybody's going. I still know where some of people are right now. You can only wear the crown if you separate yourself from the crown. Can you write it? Let it be on Instagram. Let it be on Facebook. Let it be on YouTube. If you don't go with anything, go with this. You can only wear the crown if you separate yourself from what? From the crowd. In a soccer field of 50,000 capacity, only 22 players are playing. Three referees. One on two sides. One running. Only one soccer ball. Among the 11 players, among the best of the best, they are the one champion. When Messi or Ronaldo are playing, you will see the camera following them. Let's know what Ronaldo is doing. Despite their 22 people. I want you to know, if you don't separate yourself from the crowd, you will never get the crowd. It's not for people. That is why there can never be two presidents in a country. Huh? A president, one person will be in charge. I want you to pray a prayer. Lord, if there's anybody who will be in charge, let it be me.
Amen.
Oh, it's not a man. Stand up and pray. If somebody wants to be in charge, oh Lord, let it be me. Give me the capacity of knowing you and to discover myself. Little Sabraki, a Gakukuku, Gia, Bari Ati Kotosama, Jenoruanda Baru Ketoskin de Berida, Geku Daba, Iro Kata Shatarabala. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The secret of knowing yourself is in listening to God. And one of the instructions that God gives us, Deuteronomy 28, says, if you diligently happen to the voice of the Lord, which I God has commanded you today, the Lord will set you above all nations. Amen.
Amen.
And Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. For you to know God, for God to set you up, you must come through Jesus, because it's the only way. Tonight, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, wherever you are around the world, you need to accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. Because until you know Jesus, you can never know yourself. Devil will lie to you. Your frustration is on the platform of your disconnection from Jesus. So what am I telling you tonight? Come to Jesus. Don't allow somebody to lie to you that you are going to hell. There is no hell if you accept Jesus. There is no what? There is no hell is not designed for you if you accept Jesus. No matter where you have been, the things you have done, your mistake, don't worry about it. We all been there. But hey, if you come to Jesus, the word of God said, don't want the death of the sinner, but what? Come to repentance. Wherever you are around this world, all you need to do is to put your left hand up. It's a sign of surrender. And put your right hand on your chest. It's a sign of connection. And bow down your head. It's a sign of your what? Expectation. And say to me, say this after me, Lord Jesus, I'm all yours. I know that you died for me. On the third day, you rose up again, that I might be justified. Right now, my sins are forgiven. I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus. All things have passed away. All things have become new. I receive the capacity to be able to follow you, to know you, and to know myself. Therefore, I will be devoted. I will discover. I will invest in myself, even as I be able to live as a child of God. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. I bless you with the blessing of God. May you never go down again. May the capacity needed for you to go up, and up, receive it in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, be blessed. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody shout hallelujah. We are face to face tonight with communion. What is communion? The flesh and the body and the blood of Jesus that is transferred for our own. So Jesus lived these seven power secrets. You can live the same. So when you take the communion, there's what we call blood transfusion. So, and the life of the flesh in the world is in blood. Anytime you cry in the communion, that means you are receiving the life of Jesus. Only what is permitted in Jesus is permitted in you. Stretch your hand to this communion, and whatever you are using as a symbol at home, and say, Lord, as I take the communion tonight, may this seven secret, the secret of dedication, the secret of faithfulness, the secret of activity for productivity, the secret of association, of investment, the secret of discovery and devotion, let it come upon me. Pray that prayer, pray that prayer, pray that prayer. As I take the communion tonight, a change of story in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. We bless this tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. 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 Let me fast. We are very, very, very near. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. So bless God tonight for the word. If you have been blessed, please clap your hands for Jesus. Amen. Amen. It is oftentimes, I've said it before, if you have been following us, following our teaching, never ever in your life as a believer be compared. The Bible said, help me to read it. Romans 8:14. Only those who are led are what? Are the child of God. Never be compelled to give. If the Lord lives in your heart, put it, pull the patrons link, put it there for people who want to do, because some people say maybe they don't have a Zelle or paper. So, but the email where we receive our offering and tithe right now, or the Kingdom Investment, is there at palacechapel@gmail.com. If you want to give your offering online, that's the way. If you are on ground right now, you want to send it by any means, you can stand up on your feet and let us pray. Stand up on your feet, take your offering and let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this is an offering of our understanding. As we give this offering tonight, let the seven secret power that we have talked about tonight, let it come upon us. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. This offering will be your offering of our devotion that will lead to our dedication. In the mighty name of Jesus. For those who are giving tonight, bless them. Because we are not here empty. Emptiness is not permitted. For those who want to give, we don't have. Bless the work of your hand. And they'll be able to give and give and give. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Let's give our offering and be joyful. Sing to the Lord. Lift up your hand and worship the name of the Lord. Father, we give you all the glory. Father, we give you all the honor. Father, we give you all the adoration. In Jesus' mighty name. Tonight, I bless you with the blessing of God.
Amen.
Your hand will never run dry.
Amen.
You will never align with failure again.
Amen.
You will never be found among the crowd again.
Amen.
God will separate you for his work.
Amen.
Your hand shall be blessed.
Amen.
Every of your word will find spirit fulfillment.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we are on the pathway to knowing ourselves from the scripture, may God open your eyes to scripture.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the revelation of God come upon you.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Share the goodness. Surely God's goodness, mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen. Amen.
It's my turn to shine.
Amen.
Okay, we have the prophetic focus that I said I'm going to start today. So, time has gone, we're going to do it. Divine speed is my portion. You respond, unstoppable result is for me. And we're going to echo together. With God on our side, 2021 shall produce for me. 2021 shall produce for me what?
Undeniable
results. Amen. And congratulations. Amen. We're going to, let's say it again, but we're going to put it up. Divine speed is my portion. You respond, unstoppable result is for me. With God on my side, 2021 shall produce for me undeniable results. Amen. Congratulations. Can we say it for the last time? Divine speed is my portion. Unstoppable results is for me. With God on our side, 2021 shall produce for me undeniable results. Amen. And congratulations. Give somebody a knife fight. He said, I'm on my way to knowing myself in Christ Jesus.
I'm on my way to knowing myself in Christ Jesus.